So everybody, it's Mon here. Welcome. I don't know if you're in the voice crack in the midst of this intro, but besides that, what's everybody? It's Mon here. Time for an Nerd Kids versus Battle video. One that I was thinking about after rewatching the movie. I still think probably on an 8 to 8.5 out of 10 for the movie of the Predator of Prey, aka the Forever from Yautja, the primal beastful predator. The Predator, that's the newest form of Predator, versus the iconic assassin of 2012, the character of the year of 2012, one of my favorite assassins that I feel like is underrated, Kona Kinue Arata Gaetun. This is going to be a very interesting video. I feel like this is going to be a very interesting precaution discussion when it comes down to characters and stuff like that. I can't wait to see about this. Anyway, here we go. Let's go and get into it. I love y'all. Hope you guys will enjoy it as always. Let's get it in. The Feral Predator of Prey. The Predator, also known as Yautja. I've already explained my case of far crime. Protagonist, Takar, fighting the Feral Predator in his backyard in this instance. And in this case, this will be taking place in a similar case backyard, even though in comparison with Fucker Primal's case of one archetype of the fighting in the woods, your own scrapping wouldn't be too out of pocket, but this will kind of be centered in the area where Connor is best fit, but Connor mainline has been mainly pit against a gray A form for like this, in the case of his kind of central y'all to fight in the same instance. So this would be interesting, but like I was saying, last time we had the Feral Predator face somebody was against the case of like Takar, this gray A caveman from Ubisoft's Far Cry Primal, and a gray A beast of a man when it comes down to being a hunter and things like that, and most importantly, having the ally beside him in the form of the Bloodfang Sabertooth Tiger. This will be him versus a 1v1 situation and not a 1v2 situation in this sense, so this will be very interesting to be saying at least. But still, with Feral Predator, with this a little bit more stuff to be said from seeing the actual fights and having a better remembrance of things that happened and accounting with this and a little bit of scans aligned here from the Predator with this being said and considerable case scaling from already what I've said again in my Takar versus the Predator slash Prey Predator in the case of that video. Everything I said is just a little bit of extension of it, so if you want to get more of a good baseness, you go watch that video, shameless plug. But still, involving the case of the Feral Predator from the scan I've seen, obviously killed a great deal of people, huntsmen, Native Americans with no care, had the splitting case shooter like a form of a sniper, its claws was able to tear a bear with its bare hands, outdo a wolf, kill a rabbit randomly, not that big of a feat, and then the same sense of extension of speed, has high informed human reflexes, be able to outdo bow and arrows, having a subsonic range and a reckon of speed with this being said, and then stand within a great A strength to go and face all other people, and considerably, if you want to wink, could you simply say dodging bullets, because he cloaked in between during occasions of him about to be shot. My man never actually got a strong gauge of actually outdoing bullets, unlike the counterpart to him in this fight, but in the same sense of that range of speed, I wouldn't put that. I would just say you could have him in the relativistic, even subsonic plus range, which isn't out of pocket in the kind of scaling. But again, to reiterate, in case of his counterpart and contract plane of who he'll be fighting in the case of Connor Karata Gaetun, that would be a whole different story with that being said. But that's pretty much it for Feral Predator, a great A hunter, a great A killer. This battle is going to be particularly not in the homestead, but in the case of the vast frontier, and Connor is going to be fighting him near the case of his village, so it's kind of similarity to what Prey this predator was doing in the case of a movie and things along those lines as well. So pretty much it set in stone with it being said. So I hope you guys again will enjoy this and pretty much Silver Sling in the case of things like that. Time for a boy, Connor Kinway from Assassin's Creed 3. Connor Kinway, Orata Agetun, meaning the scarred, the scarce in the sense of bringing the scarce or the form of someone shut out in the case of means, what is being said of life. Born in 1755 in the Cotonou, correct me if I'm wrong with how I'm saying and probably butchering that, of Native American blood. Being the son of Kanavizio, coming from a butcher in the name to Prisho Rada Agetun is the correct way to say it, and son of Hafem Kinway, son of Edward Kinway, the great pirate assassin, and him being a Templar with assassin roots, which is being said, was born, like I said, in a Native American village off to the north side of the frontier, the vast frontier, beautiful case map, which is being said. And at a young age, was hanging out with his friends in the case of Kidville, as you see in the case of Cam, that you'll see later on. And in the midst of playing hide and seek and hiding, got found out by the colonists, or in this case, Hafem's Templar buddies. And the reason why, in case you guys don't know, Hafem didn't come and see someone like Zio is kind of explained with her, like, monologue introduction. But in the midst of it, it's pretty much that she found out who Hafem was and was afraid about how Hafem would be like to their child and the type of kid Connor would grow to be like, what is being said, and also finding that he was just there only snooping around and possibly did not love her and was only snooping around to find a precursor site, what is being said. And so she shunned him out and banished him from her village and told him never to return. Exxon this motherfucker, done with him. And sorry for that in the case of my phone, but continuing on with this being said, sorry, I have something in my throat. Pause with that being said. Continuing on, mainline point is that Connor obviously didn't have a father figure. Not the fact that he left him, especially since he didn't even know of Connor's existence. And my man never had to pay child support, so he's like, I don't got a kid. I had a little thing with a shorty, so I'm gonna go ahead and just be out with this being said. After being again banned, shunned with this being said from her people and all accounts of any type of love and people that he could have, especially remember in the case of his introduction in the game, he helped out Kanzeel. What is being said in the case of her people and everything like that, but within helping Kanzeel, if I'm getting you saying it, Kanzeel with her, or just Zeo as she shortened it, did not take away from the fact that, again, he was kind of using them just to get to something, and possibly just be playing them, then eventually getting whatever he wanted, then he would pull out from even being there, unlike how he did with Zio and having Connor, with this being said. But in the midst of Connor seeing the colonists after being bullied and called names and being choked out by Charles Lee, the bitch, the pedophile himself, his pedophile Mario mustache, the bitch himself, he would have to go ahead and go back to his village being knocked out. And seeing his village flamed on and ruined, he would see his mother die, being under rubble, the entire police crumbling, and not being able to save his mother would scar him. He would grow, obviously, into a young adult, going on a great adventure run to go and find the old assassin, Achilles, at the homestead, with this being said, and he would train under him in pursuance to, well, the form of Juno telling her that he needed to go ahead and go there, what is being said, and then in the mix, Ojuno telling him that he needed to go ahead and go there, also find Charles Lee, kill him, and then in precaution, because he knows that people will come for his land, his people, his home, he wanted to go and defend them, which is his whole purpose of pushing for the means of freedom, which is why no matter the case, he backs the means of pushing against the British and making the case of what the idea of America to become a real thing and not give up on it and stay in his pursuit to find a way to make freedom be absolute, what is being said. So Yeah, that's the pretty much like synopsis story of Connor with other case of things, and he would go for a great deal of development, grade A skills, grade A character, and turn into a brutal assassin that would be a key part of the American Revolution, what is being said. Either way, though, time to go ahead and talk about case of Connor's abilities, what he can do, and everything things besides regard of his history, what that being said, and why this underrated assassin is a beast in his own right. Connor Kenway, the beast, we all know him to be a very roundabout fighter. I've talked about Connor twice in the sense of a power scam, which is being said, and defended this man on different accounts involving being an underrated case form for whether in the case of the series, in some cases of power scaling talks about what he can do and different things like that. Not saying people necessarily think he's like underrated in the form of regard fine, because everybody knows this man is a slugger, a bruiser, a brutacious man, slaying multi redcoats, patriots, all type of niggas that get in his way, getting slapped up multiple times over. This man is the type of motherfucker to start a bar fight, to go ahead and just start bonding with his grandfather Edward, which I think Edward will very much like Connor, and Connor will like him too. But besides that, Rauta Gaethoom, like I still said, is a very roundabout anatomy fighter that can point blank move out of bullets with just walking, running a little bit, dodge, anatomy in the same sense of showcasing of being a fighter, and multi times have been slaughtering multi cases of different militaries and their men multiple times, with this being said. In the case of anatomy and efficiency, with this being said, the Templar's worst fear. This is the one nigga you do not want coming after you, as he will tear for your men, run for your whole army, multi-case slaughtering them niggas with no case of compassion. My man been able to move around things multiple times over. Man is very strong, fierce, agile, anatomy, has great aim martial arts in case of weapon skill, with his iconic tomahawk and split him. Assassin's Creed blade knife function, where he's very ambidextrous and dynamic and versatile with it. He's a master in the form of regard of slinging slash form grappling of things, is being said, mixed with pro wrestling, street fighting, mixed of technical sling attributes within the case of being on a climb in his parkour, intricate into his dynamic CFO showing in the form of fighting and different things along those lines. And also, again, with his assassins, because being taught by Achilles, which gives him a great deal of master form case classes, being said, killed multiple case Templars, killed his own father, even though his father has been theored and debated to have let him kill him. It doesn't take away the fact that he still killed him, still got the job done, still showed out in the capabilities that he has. And most importantly, he was injured, so in full case, ready to run at stage, no nerve, technical stage, and injury. With both of them and technical emotion took into play, I feel like it would be a very close contingent 50-50 match. But I believe Connor is of the potential to have killed his father if he was going all out in full. And again, wasn't in slight place of holding back, because obviously it's his father, and Connor doesn't know OJ, his own father. Also corresponding with this, with Connor being again a very dynamic, versatile, brutacious, a nab, a Native American beast when it come down to his stance, his full showing skill and other things like that. He can showcase greater form skill in the regards of his hunting, great again, climbing, parkour, his pool, different gymnastics, keeping his own Nightwing stuff, but to a greater deal, he holds a bow and arrow, two pistols, depending on the case. And what is also being said, his other different capabilities would be reasonably used in this. We're talking about base equipment, and then when we go by game, you have multi-assortment with, obviously, you have a general form knife, stances of mix-up capabilities in the form of your right hidden blade and to the left form hidden blade. You have your tomahawk, sword, club, axe, your gun, bow and arrow, in case of trip mine, snag, rope dart, poison darts. You also have smoke bombs, things like that. He has a multi-accessory of different things to be able to use, and he's a very proficient fighter, has ran for multiple case of bullets, is easily on the supersonic plus dance scale of speed, with this being said, without question. Now, I want to go and debunk a thing that's been saying that Connor is not faster than bullets or any other character in Assassin's Creed hypothetical, because of the fact, like a big case saying about any character that seems out of place to be able to dodge bullets, is just aim dodging, like they're just in reaction time and a tentacle perception, seeing when you're gonna be able to shoot it before you do, slash they're perceiving it as that, just in the mindset of guessing, which you would have to actually proudly prove, and there is no proof against this. There's no way you mix the character in verse would be able to do that by the tentacle. Now you could probably see them doing it more, but it's a mixed take of saying that he could actually guess, and then flat out because Connor's fast and both making him super Sonic Plus, what he's being said, not hypersonic, because I got into a discussion with a dude trying to say that Ezio, you know, I don't know much about him, even though I am playing his games, by the time that you are seeing this, and I went for all of them, what is being said, and I'm trying to go a full recording put out to you guys, especially playing multi other ports or different shit, and busting ideas to put forth what is being said, when the time comes and all of it, that this boy Ezio is not hypersonic. You moving faster than bullets in general does not make you hypersonic unless there's a stance into inverse or higher regard caliber near that stance into weight, and it's a different type of bullet. General bullets, human based thing, earth, especially we're talking about the 18th century muskets, my nigga, he would not be faster than the speed of a speedster when they're first starting out. He would be supersonic plus by all regimen of, again, the factor that he is moving faster than when they can pull, even when the shots are being shot off, what is being said by that. You know how the general singing that faster than the speeding bullet? He's faster than the speeding bullet, and by caution of how he, again, is moving, getting a case of grappling by the time of shooting it, dodging it just by jumping, moving in different showcases, that instantly shows he's faster than bullets, and this has been shown multiple times over in the game. This has been shown even with other characters that Connor should either scale to or upscale, like he's getting in front of Edward or Shay, where in their similar games they dodge bullets. Ezio in his game has dodged a cannonball, dodged bullets in their encounters, should be similar to other people. Arno completely just deliberately dodges bullets on a regular. He doesn't even need to really look or feel any big shame. He's scaling the people that by general case range to where you should be getting pop and not considerably from different kind of range where you're moving from a mixed stasis of movement, where these niggas are clearly just missing, right? Not being out of place in the case of movement, what is being said. These niggas instead are right at Arno's face and they just duck or dodge roll. With that being said, they'll do a barrel roll to pull fire giant, my nigga. Just move out the way with no care. They did a tactical roll mid-shot of your musket, your footlock, where the fuck it may be. Just straight up dodge, my nigga. No care. There's no way quantifiably that you can tell me indirectly by him doing this stuff, it is him aim perceived dodging. It's not no Batman shit, which even in an all higher skill, Batman can dodge bullets. It's no semi-precognition because Eagle Vision, because he doesn't even activate that to do that. It really makes sense. It would probably even be harder to do that. It would mess up his vision. Your sixth sense is supposed to help an area effect, not stasis of that perceived dodge. And even in precognition, does not deform or downgrade the capability to dodging there before. Now granted, it is that, but you still have to be of the capability to react to it. It's also the same stance for, even though Heimdall will get catch, why Heimdall is in contingent to seriously in different forms better in comparison to someone like Kratos in the plane of speed, because when he's dodging, he has to have the hyper sense to actually do that. With that being said, on a figurative sense of scale and speed, because to make this clear to rescind my statement, he on a comparatively form sense, so that's even a sense of word, yeah, with it being said, has to use strong sharpness in mind, precision, and base of movement to then catch him off guard, do anything to him, which, you know, he does, and he has capability to, which is where, again, relative, and he has a speed and hacks ways to, and this is shown multiple times. So regardless if you think it's, I don't know, him having a better mindset or any character in fiction like this, they do have to be fast enough to dodge these things. No matter Heimdall, Sonic, Spider-Man, Raiden, and if you want to stretch the bar, I don't know, King Kong, because of his hyperform senses, because he's a big-ass gorilla, I don't know, like something like that. No matter how the people's mind works from the sense of their advantage, their reflexes and accounting of speed needs to be of that, and that would even just consider be up the stance of like high end great senses and skill because he's so advanced in his plane of a brawl sense that he can react in a higher perception than even trained Grade A soldiers of the Great British Army, which again he wrecks multi case armies and the same sense of people. What is being said from the Great British to the Patriots, don't matter who gets in Connor's way, you are getting slept is most of the precautions of things. So yeah, that's the thing about Connor, that's the thing about him as a person in general. So yeah, that's pretty much it when it comes down to Connor in the sense of speed. With it being said, again, like I said, supersonic plus, dodging muskets, dodging pistols, dodging a bunch of other case instances and stuff, great A fast, has small building level case instances of durability. With this being said, as he was able to take a boulder straight to the back, been able to rival people who have taken them the same or similar, that's pretty consistent. With that being said, he's of the low to great mid stance of small building level, not plus I would say entirely, I would say he's just more relative, because again he's only took him two or three things that hold a reasonable representation of that being a stance of possibility of really like striking bar of that. So that's why I would say Rob to Gaytoon is that when it comes down to his overarching pack of skill. With that being said, but yeah, that's pretty much it when it comes down to his overarching count of skill, different things like that. Time to get into the actual midst of the fight. With this being said, fight is going to be taking, like I said, Frontier, not Homestead, not New York, not Boston, not over at West Point. This is taking place in Mario Gray Woods. The Federal Predator is going after Connor. Been looking for him, seeking best type of census way of opening for him to show up and fight him. Connor's doing his regular thing, scouting, doing whatever, like this place is in a death battle, so scouting, peeking out, maybe hunting. The Federal Predator is hunting him. He's been looking out far and wide of how the area is like and best capabilities to hunt and kill, killing some great British, some patriots, and general animals. Been against very foggy things about how this case confrontation eventually with whoever this manhunter is, by beast or actual man, from Connor's point of view. Rod to Gaytoon goes to scouts in the woods, goes all pushes like a one-man army, and then in the midst of the Feral Predator again speaking, in the sense of whoever his tongue is, in the mix of showcasing himself to Connor from the shadows of the trees, coming out uncloaked, ready to go ahead and fight, with this being said. But in the midst, because Connor has different case weapons, and like the car, he has club, possibly, that was from a different point, or in a sense, with him having an ammo with him, there's going to be a lot more use of their different capabilities, with this being said. And I'm going to explain some things in the midst of the battle correspond with this, but simply put, because of the fact that Connor would not know indirectly of his presence, because I want to put some narrative in, like I said, this man, Pharaoh, sneaks up on him, again from the trees, over here hunting him, Prowler getting on him, Aztec, also Lotto, been hunting this man, and this man, jogging about in the forest, peeking about, running around, not knowing of him, and not knowing this beast is a true predator as a case of animal, or man, and it's kind of been a foggy shake of things, evolving the count of who he is. And Connor could be going out to pick for himself, or George Washington, or by call whoever, because of fear going about in the homestead of his people. Again, this is the frontier, not too far from the homestead in the grand scope, seeing about everything coming to play. My man Connor almost gets shot by one of his spear tings, but he doesn't. Now, for the record, if we want to be realistic in a case of consistency, Connor would outdo the Feral Predator in every regard by speed alone, decimated just by clear case movement. So there's no way that the Feral Predator can even keep up with Connor or do anything to him. So Connor would speed blitz and that'd be the end of it, especially with his weaponry and the Feral Predator face him like Connor. But I don't want to have it just be at the point of contingent with everything else kind of in gadgets, and obviously his durability and plenty of attack potency is not. And now let's try to take away the actual consistency of him and try to put that as something of that weight, then that can't happen. But I don't, again, want it to just be met at these case of contingents and not have it be anywhere else with this being said, right? So I'm going to go and be equalizing the stats, both supersonic plus, obviously. The kids, everything else is going to be in their own case of regard of even to better showcasing, right? Maybe in the case of gadget capabilities of use for the Pharaoh, even though someone like Connor has a great versatility of his tech slash arsenal, what is being said. And again, the repetition, I don't want to have it just be met at that, in the sense of the case of things where it's going to be those capabilities in arsenal, and then without a shadow of doubt, Connor just eases up on the same sense of feeling like he's out of his zone, then just gets in piercing blood, about to get smoke case moves, and just rams this motherfucker with his fist, what is being said, through the chin and through the skull, because he should fucking obliterate this man just in a millisecond of speed, right? I want to have it be met at an even stand sense of feel. I want to have it be ending in a considerable credit, right? So we're going to be utilizing the stats, and we're going to see how things go. But continuing onward, my man Connor dodges out the way, puts out a few of those. It crooks him in the case almost within the same sense of SWAT going after him. He flicks into a case of like this jaguar sense and stance move, like how Wolverine with his claws is like, what is being said. Connor is maneuvering, darting around. He flicks out his tomahawk with the slip of his hidden blade knife on the left side. He's rocking with the feral predator. They going at it contingent, paw for ball, paw for paw, like he would with a great British coat in this instance. So with that being said, that's where the fight comes with being said of a fighting sense. And so in the midst of, you know, all accounting of fighting and paw for paw, ball for ball, what is being said, he slips in there, since it's a plick, the feral predator comes after him within a still mix of plucking it. Connor swipes it with his tomahawk. They fight and they jacking with each other. Connor's using his great capabilities, and he's rocking between split of them fighting in between bushes, him crawling on him, moving around him, prowling moves. Connor, Native American beast with the Eagle State sight, tries popping him with an arrow within a swift move of his bow and arrow, and he actually pierces the feral predator. What is being said on the even stasis of speed almost, but it just skins him, and then he pulls out his guns, he shoots him, but he obviously dodges because of equal speed. And then from there going forward, he tries to go and wrestle with him. They rocking with each other. A very great A fight. He's skinning Connor Stanson's of great A suit, which busts in the case of design. I love the grand blue American patriotic fighter case in the sense of design, what is being said. But still, he's great A fighting the man, trying to do the best he can when it comes down to the stand of actually fighting another great A things, is being said. But it is not working all around his favor too much, in the same sense of one, the foul predator being considered to be possibly bigger than Connor's. Connor's been, as mentioned, be like maybe like 6'2, 6'3, and they're in the count, like in his different build. Tyreek, you watch me, because the wolf head being like 6'4. I don't know, I've seen mixed records, but Connor's like a 6'2 to 6'3 individual, I would say. Tall, busting motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Motherfucker be brawlic as hell with his moves. No homo. My man Connor got a very dope case build. This man be having the fucking Twitter stands on his ass in the case of his straightforward beast dog case build. Like I said, big dog, great A fighter, ruthless, busting case visual when it comes down to his speed and air stuff like that. But he, you know, is rocking with the feral predator, holding his own. Great A dynamic C in the sense of his full showing and cutting edge capabilities. The feral predator tries his best to go ahead and rock with Connor and be even, but in the midst between the bushes and mix of the trees and popping off with the darts of his split and doing things, Connor, like Wolverine versus the predator, outdoes him in a lot of his shine of skill capabilities of distribution in the case of anatomy, defense and offense, and closes out the things. I feel like he wrap around him, and eventually after great A going a distance stance as a fight would cut him up, chip him, and a split at the heart, chop stays at the liver side on the left side, then split cut chop on the case of the neck, rocking him to the floor and chopping him in the heart. What is being said, and he gets a synchronized moment in the midst of splitting him with the hidden blade, and the feral predator just kind of smiles in a way with his crab face and then laughs as the bomb points gets picked up, and Connor books it. You're running here, a track star, off into the frontier mass woods, in the case, climbing trees, moving around, and in ironic fashion, a great deal of the frontier blows up, but Connor makes it out alive in a good sweep. We have his clothes on fire, almost buried against the rubble of the rest of the wreckage of things. Everybody spooked about where the fuck happened. It's the first time in the 18th century where motherfuckers really thinking that doomsday was gonna come in the same sense, because that bomb would be leaving a nuke size thing. With this being said, so yeah, Connor will get out. I feel like he'll be fine, be torn from the battle, but we'll get Gold good in case of patching and things like that. I don't think we'll leave too much of a heavy stinging mark, because Connor is that dude. With that being said, simple as always, all around, like I said, I think Connor wins a great deal, like 8.5 to 9 times out of 10, even with equal speed, because Connor is a beast, a great A fighter, is one of the greatest fighters in the history verse, from everything that I've studied and researched and looked about. I hope you guys have enjoyed Dope Case of Battle, Dope Case of Conversation when it comes down to the character. I love doing stuff like this. If you want to see more, go let me know. I like doing this case of conversation. The Prey Movie is cool. I love Connor. One of my favorite Assassin's Creed protagonists and one of my favorite protagonists in video games. Do not worry about that in the background. Besides that, joke aside, I love y'all. I'm going to see you guys in the next one. Peace out, mommy. Love y'all.